Hi everyone, I'm Jennifer Miles. I'm a teaching associate here at Monash University in the Faculty of Education. I'm passionate about supporting people in learning and understanding learning. Online discussion boards are a really great complement to the learning that you're doing in a face-to-face environment. The understanding that you're gaining through your reading, through the discussions that you have with your peers. What I want you to gain from this is that it's an opportunity for you to be able to reflect critically on everything that's going on, to be able to bring your experience, your thoughts, your questions, any lack of understanding you might have about it, to bring that with you. The most important thing you can bring to this is yourself and your thoughts to connect with the literature that you might be discussing or the other conversations that your colleagues are having. I want you to come out of this with new ways of seeing the world and new ways of understanding the world. The topic heading that you would use relates to what is being asked of you. And I would suggest that you put some of your own thoughts in there and to connect it with the topic. For instance, you might be looking at Brookfield and his theories on learning and teaching. So you might put a heading of thinking about Brookfield and his ways of engaging with learning and teaching. And then you're very clear about what your post is going to be about, and then make sure that you follow through with what you're writing. There's many ways of looking at appropriateness or inappropriateness. One of the things that first comes to mind for me is about positive language. When we look at the field of disability, there is a whole range of literature that talks about positive language. For instance, rather than saying that somebody suffers with a mental illness, you speak about the fact that somebody lives with a mental illness. Not that somebody is bound by a wheelchair, but they use their wheelchair for mobility. So there's that perspective. The words that we use have a very great impact on how things are seen and understood and the message that it actually sends across. What we're looking to do is to connect with people, to connect with ideas, to encourage other people in what they have to say. So think about the language that you use and the way that it might encourage or discourage that. Connect to what people are saying. You may have had to discuss Brookfield's article. When you're responding to somebody else's comment, bring that into the conversation. Say, I really like what John's got to say about Brookfield. I really appreciate his perspective on whatever it might be. I think most importantly, bring yourself into the conversation. The response that is required is not disconnected from you. You have to bring your experience, your perspective, what you understand about it all, and then link it to the literature, to the conversation, to whatever it is that you're being asked to link it to. Your voice is important, your perspective is important, but you need to back it up with literature. And if you do those things and you're clear about what it is you're supposed to be doing, you should get a good response about that. Whatever you're going to do, give yourself time to immerse yourself into the thinking so that you can really get your brain thinking critically about how you might best respond to it. What are other people saying? How does that influence your thinking? And then write some of those things. Use your time well and invest in it well.